lined up, not broken, etc. That tile is gonna get fixed. In your favor. For every two opportunities the boss has, you should get one, right? And this one had like 5 to 0. You were basically, you're in some upside down water and you're above a Lemmy. And there's 3 dick ghosts that fly around. And also the Lemmy is like protected by these death blocks when he pops up. So what it means is that you have to, and also there's no patterns. There's no consistent pattern. So you had to be in the right spot when Lemmy popped up, just already there, and then have him pop up and have him do the right animation so that his hitbox is big enough for you to actually hit it. And then you had to also hope that there were no dick ghosts in your way. Oh my word, that dodge though. And then and get 3 hits that way while dodging stuff underwater. Bro, I'm trying my best to have a 105 for you. Ooh, I made it. Yeah. Dude, one shot in all the checkpoints. You guys can always, you know, come by and ask questions or whatever, or just tweet me, or just, you know, whatever. Feel free. If you're streaming it, I will find you. I will find you, I will follow you, I will try to host you. There we go. There we go. Not a lot. Okay, cool. I know sometimes it can be concerning if he's not around. I'm concerned too sometimes if I just don't see him. Where is he? He's somewhere in the house. Alright, let's just get this right, man. There, that's all you had to do. And the kitty coin on the way down. Oh, I dig that, man. It's like how do you prove you're tough, you know? You just go up to the, you go into the bar and go up to the biggest, baddest dude and be like, yo, I'm gonna fight you and then win. Like, I can see it. Like, from his, like, I get why someone would want to just start out with Kaizo 3. Like, why, you know, why not? Like, why not just take on the biggest, baddest one? You know, even if it's gonna be kind of insane, you know, then you did it. Don't worry, Bongo Kitties don't eat much. They eat the spare bits that fall out of streamers' cups. They're perfectly happy. They're not like a Gigapet or a Tamagotchi. Damn, those things are annoying. Beep! 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 God damn, this level is just so cool. So cool. You don't have to die to get this. Tiny tap jump. Awesome. But yeah, you know, especially with everybody with the recent surge of interest in Kaizo 3 and the fact that, you know, I've beaten it, so I feel like I've earned the right to try to go beyond, you know what I mean, because I've beaten one of the hardest games out there, and I'll beat other ones too. So it's just like I'm trying to, there we go. I think someday I might even try to speedrun Odyssey. Do the learn the any percent route and just get a PB. I'm never gonna be running it at GDQ or anything, but it's a really cool game. It's a really cool speedrun, and even though I got kinda tired of it. Like, as a 100% grind. Man, the speedrun is just awesome. It really is. Oh, yeah. I love that ending, man.
Kappa, 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 GC7 Live.
Kappa attack. Thank you so much, Dark Soldier, for the Kappa attack. D-Kappa attack. I really appreciate that, man. I love that part. Hey, what's up, Haywire? Go, 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 go. I could do 360 speedruns in 1 hour. Oh, so it's like what? Like a 2 minute run or something? So it's like Moon Master. Yeah, actually this might be one of the most unintuitive tricks in the game. This one coming up right here. I would love to make real life Bongo Kitty coins. That would make me happy to have. One shot, dude. One shot. One shot. One freaking shot. Love it. See, that part's not bad. You guys know for a fact that you're getting a shout out from the couch, right? Like, there's no way I could even get off the stage without being like, shout outs to my community on Twitch. I love you guys. Like, there's no, you know what I mean? Like, there's no way that's not gonna happen. What's up, Freezinator? Hey, bud.
Greetings, Glitch Cat and Glitch Chat. I have money to spare once again, and I am proud to be resubbing for month number 13, going partially in 214 GC7 Kitty.
Thank you so much, Freezinator, dude. Welcome back. I'm glad you're here. Let's get a caster command for Freezinator. I haven't seen you on for a minute, but you still stream. My hood was wrapped up in this game, and all my life, since I was 4 years old, I have played video games, especially Super Mario World. But not only just played them, I wanted to know everything. I wanted to know how to do all the tricks, all the secrets, everything. I wanted to be really, really good. And I've never not felt that way in my entire life. So what you're seeing is the result of 26 years playing this game. And that's how. That's how I did it. I started when I was 4. Not saying you have to do that in order to get good. But it kind of helps. Alright, Dagula, have a good one, man. Thanks for watching. I know it sounds so corny, but like, it's true. It's true. I would imagine something like a GDQ, you know, where there'd be like an announcer, like a sports game. That's what I thought, you know. And there'd be an announcer, and he'd be like, "Oh, he hit the shell there, but he didn't get the Yoshi. Oh, jeez." And I would imagine that kind of thing. And it's true. It's actually true. Now that's my job. It's like somehow I knew. I didn't know. Pro tip, I had no idea. Yatta. I wanna see Lightning Bolt. No, I made it. Oh, I made it. Oh, I really thought I was dead there. Hey, exactly. Exactly, confusion. Sometimes you want to keep racing even though nobody else... You know, even though you know it'll make it hard. I mean, I am now the discouragement squad for Cool Spot. Like, if I would have left the record at 10:30 or something, you know, people would have been like, oh, cool, I could maybe go, you know, try this out. But 9:59 is discouraging. It is. In there. It. This level is the spiritual successor to Shun River from Breakfast Kaizo. In fact, I would say that Shun River flows out of here. Yeah! If it's one frame, it basically, it looks magical. Like, if you look at it and it doesn't look magical, it's probably not one frame. Alright, let's go. Coolest trick in the game, right at the end. Oh yeah, check it out. Now let's just not nigh. Yes, this isn't the end because the drop is consistent enough that you should just get... Alright, here's my boss. Again, if you haven't seen this boss, it's not the greatest boss ever. It's not the most, holy crap, I can't believe that's so innovative thing ever in the whole wide world, but I think it's good. It's fun, it's challenging, it's relatively short. It doesn't need to be terrorizingly hard. It doesn't, you know, I don't need Kaizo 3 Bowser. I don't need Grand Pooh World Bowser here. That's a little bit overboard for me. It's just quick, it's patterns. Yo, thanks Mathtronic. I'm glad, I hope you guys like watching it. You know, I understand, you know, playing it is a whole nother story, but I hope you like watching it, because I spent a lot of time making it extra cool.